together, amen, amen can work signs and wonders and can undo whatever the devil has done or established, amen, in your life. Because in unity there is what? Strength. Amen. It was Charles Finney that was a famous evangelist, and he sent a man before him before every revival, and he was called Father Nash, and he would pray in the spirit, just bawl and cry and weep and just really intercede. And he would go and start the prayer meeting, getting people what praying together, get them on one accord. And they say that in one particular revival, when they began to pray like that, and Charles Finney came into town, and see, the atmosphere was already established because people had gotten together and went pray. And they said everybody in that town, like in a 3-mile radius, was saved. Every single person in a 3-mile radius. Wouldn't that be good? How many believe that you could get everybody saved in a 3-mile radius? Would that be a major feat?
Yes.
But that was the secret. All of them. Even Sister Pearl couldn't have done it by herself. Sister Sharon couldn't have done it by herself. But when everybody came together, everybody would pour out their heart to God, then that prayer became what? Very, very powerful. Amen. Praise God. And as a result, everybody in a 3-mile radius was saved. And except for one person. Amen. And they got together and they prayed, and that one person, amen, got saved as well. So everybody eventually got saved. Amen. So I want you to just look through these scriptures. And when you come to prayer, we're going to be praying these in the morning. Amen. And I don't just be reading them and just say, well, let's go to the next one. Let's go down to the next one. I don't do it that way. I just read these, and you can just read them. The Lord will begin to what? Quicken these spirit, you know, these scriptures. Amen. And these scriptures will begin to become what? Alive as you begin to look up. Amen. Look at them and read them. Amen. These scriptures are really good. Scripture says that faith without works is dead. Amen. It speaks a lot about showing yourself a pattern of good works, provoking one another to love and to good works. And at the bottom of page 56, it says, made able ministers of the new covenant. Amen. He has made us able ministers. Everybody said, I've been made an able minister. Given power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases what? Strength. They that what? Wait on the Lord. These are scriptures that you will find under made able ministers of the new covenant. Amen. And not by power, nor by might, but my spirit, said the Lord. The spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me. Amen. Can we apply that to ourselves? The spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Have you ever heard anybody around you say, the spirit of the Lord is upon me? Have you ever heard anybody sit around you?
Yeah.
All right. Amen. We need to hear it what? More. The Spirit of the Lord is what? It's upon me because he hath what? Anointed me. How many believe you've been anointed?
Amen.
How many believe you're anointed to preach, to share?
Yeah.
How many believe that you're anointed to heal the brokenhearted,
yeah,
to preach deliverance?
Yeah.
That's what you're for, made for. As God's workmanship, you were created for that particular purpose, to show forth his glory, his glory, amen, to show forth, the chosen generations and a royal priesthood, called to show forth his glory, who have called us out of darkness unto this what marvelous light. All of those scriptures are in here somewhere. Amen. Praise God. And all of his fullness, this is on page 58, and of his fullness have all we received, and grace upon grace. Now, if you read through all of these, and just 3 or 4 are quickened, amen, we ought to be able to get something out of some of these, because y'all have heard me say these continuously. On page 58, it says, and of his fullness, St. John 1:16, And of his fullness have all we received, and what? Grace, grace for grace. Amen. I want you to open your mouth and just say, of his fullness have I received. Of his fullness. Amen. The fullness of God is the Holy Spirit. Amen. Of his fullness, we have already what? Received. That's the fullness of the Godhead. Amen. The Holy Spirit. Amen. We have already received. Amen. You believe that can make you really happy when you just begin to say that? Of his fullness have I received. And what? Grace upon what? Grace. Grace upon grace. Grace upon grace. Amen. And you know, all of these are so good. They which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life. Lord, I thank you that I have received the what? Abundance of grace and the what? Gift of what? Righteousness. And I what? And I reign. In this thing. In other words, I'm the ruler, I'm the master, I'm on top. No weapon formed against me will what? Prosper. I'm the one that called the shots. The devil can't rule, dictate, and control me any longer. So these are scriptures that will enable you. Amen. Now, we focused a lot last month or so on the Lord's compassion. But this is, amen, focusing more on the compassion of the Lord working through you. The Lord's compassion working through what? Me. And that's the reason why we're going to be able to do the works of Jesus, because God has what? Given us everything that pertains unto what? Life and godliness. Amen. I want to stop here, but this is going to be the month that we're going to focus on reaching the lost, beginning in the mode, amen, to get into the homes, and all of this prayer has got to be what? Taken into the homes. Amen. There's no point in us just praying here all the time. And members, now how many prayer requests do we have tonight? Amen, that we can offer up. Let's just acknowledge some of the prayer, people that need prayer. So we won't just be self-centered and we're here to get, you know. Okay? All right, who is it that?
Sister Pearl here.
Okay, Sister Pearl.
Sister Helen said that Eric's dad is in the hospital.
Okay, the brother?
Eric's father.
Eric's father, okay. Okay, let's acknowledge those that need prayer.
Lena Hatcher.
Okay.
She's home, recovering from knee surgery.
Mm-hmm. Okay, she's at home, recovering from knee surgery. Okay. Is there anybody else?
My mother's sister.
Okay, your mother's sister is, what kind of problem needs you? Okay. All right. Well, Brother Rod, I want you to get ready to pray. Amen. Brother Curtis. Amen.
Sister Yvonne.
Brother.
Yes.
Brother Trent. Okay. Sister who? Sister Yvonne. Okay. These are members. Sister Yvonne, Sister Gina. They are members of the church. And Sister Holman, her aunt. Amen. Is there anybody else that needs prayer? Eric's father. Okay. All right. Amen. We're going to come into agreement, and we're going to spend a little time in praying for those needs. And we want to invite you to, we'll begin to reach out on Sunday, people that have needs and people that want to, we used to have a prayer request board box somewhere, didn't we? Yes. So we want to start focusing on those needs that we know about, so that we can just intercede for them while we're here, so that we can show our love and release our mercy, amen, toward those that have need. Because if we have mercy, the Bible says God will what? He will release his mercy into our lives. All right, we're going to have brother, amen, we're going to have three brothers to pray. We've got 10 minutes to pray, amen. And as we pray and intercede for those that we...
We do have an announcement, too.
Okay. Okay, okay, we have an announcement. So, okay, we'll get that on the end. All right. Okay, let's pray. We're going to pray for the saints. God stir them, God shake them. And, Amen. We are praying for revival this month. Amen. Prayer revival. But it's not going to be a revival in which we just come, go back. But as we go, I'm going into home, contacting people every day. Amen. Today, oh, it was a good today. I was at McDonald's, and somebody I had been praying for, Brother Nathaniel Bentham, walked in McDonald's. And I've been asked us to share, do you know how to get in contact with him? I've been asking. She said, no. I've been going all over the place trying to locate his business, and I just wasn't successful. He was a young man that moved to Tulsa when we first came? Shortly after we moved here, and he moved from Arkansas. And he's a wonderful young man, has a beautiful family. And I just think all it would take is somebody to spend some time with him. He walked right there. Amen. Praise God. I got that name and phone. Well, I already knew him, but I got his phone number. Amen. So if you have a heart for people, God is going to cause people to cross your path. And he's going to place you in a position where you're going to be able to. This is what we're praying for this month. Suppose God, all of us would pray, Lord, send somebody across my path that I can help, that I can minister to, that I can pray for, that I can develop a relationship with. Amen. This is what we're praying for this morning, this month, so that our walk with the Lord won't just be all about ourselves. All right, come on, Brother Rob Dennis. And all of those prayers about the lost and reaching out and evangelism, all of those prayers are the prayers that we want to incorporate in our prayers this month. Amen. Amen.
Father, we thank you and we come before you today. And we ask that you just give a touch to all those that are needing you right now, Father.
Yes.
We thank you for your blessings. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you for your grace.
Yes.
Father, we know that you are willing to bless and touch all of those. We know that you have a desire to save those that are yours. Father, we thank you and we honor you today. We honor you as always. And we continually ask you to send someone across our path. Let us be the vessels that you work through. Give us the strength and give us the courage to speak boldly your word. Give us the ability, Father, to do the things that you would have us to do for your people. Father, we thank you that we are here today and we are here to honor you and to praise you in all that we do and all that we say. Each and every day we give to you.
Yes.
Lord, for all those that are not here tonight, for all those that are not able to be here,
yes,
we stand in the gap for them.
Yes.
We stand on your word.
Oh,
and Father,
yes,
we ask your blessings and your mercies and your grace upon all those that are needing you right now.
Yes.
Father, we honor you with our prayers. We honor you at all times.
Yes.
And we hope that you would find us holy and worthy,
yes,
of all your prayers. Father, thank you for your word.
Yes.
Thank you for always upholding your word. You have never left us. You have never left us. You have never, your word has never returned void. Father, today is the day that we honor you, and today is the day that we will always honor you. Your praises will always be on our lips. We will always give you thanks and give you glory and give you honor and praise your holy name. Father, thank you for your touch for all those that are needing you now. Thank you for your blessings and your mercies and your grace. In your Son, Jesus' name, we ask all these things because we know that you are able and you are willing. We thank you, Father, that every day as we go forward, you will fill us with your spirit, fill us with your love, your compassion, and your kindness toward everyone that we see and everything that we do. Everything that we touch, Father, we do it in the name of you. We do it to your glory, for your glory's satisfaction. Father, today we honor you. We praise your holy name. And we thank you. We thank you. We thank you, and we thank you. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, my God. Thank you for that prayer that Brother Rogers preached, my God. Lord, we thank you, mighty God, for bringing us in, mighty God.
And
praise you, mighty God. We give you the honor, mighty God. Lift your name up, God. We just thank you for this, mighty God. Because we just give you all the glory, all the honor. We want to touch each one of them that we call on today, mighty God. Wherever they at, go ahead and just sit right next to them, mighty God. And whisper sweet things to them. Let them know that you on their side, that you is willing to do whatever they have to do to heal whatever they need to heal, mighty God. mighty God. We ask you, mighty God, to go sit right next to him, mighty God. Go sit, go and sit next to Eric, Father. Whatever his need is, heal that body. Heal it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever it is, mighty God, we ask you right now, we are going to intercede right now that you will heal that body. Go to Sister Homer, Auntie, whoever she is. Go and heal that counsel. We still believe that, hey, you is a God, you is a healing God. You can still work miracles, mighty God.
Person. What is your coming from? How she don't have it? How she Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank Heavenly Father for Pastor Hill and Sister here, Heavenly Father. Thank you that we have a friend, Pastor Father. Thank you for evangelism. And we claim that he's going to reach those 100 households.
Just going to begin to just use everybody in prayer. Everybody get ready now. Amen. Me and Brother Travis, we ain't going to do it all. Amen. Amen. This year, every person, we're going to just free you. Amen. And you get ready, Sister Pearl. Get ready, Sister Pearl. Amen. Every week, we're going to have three or four people, just like tonight. In the morning, you going to be here in the morning? Uh-huh. Okay, all right. I want you to have a good prayer in the morning. The church needs to be stirred. Evangelism, whatever the Lord lays on your heart, you know what needs to be. Are you ready? Amen. Well, I don't know, Brother Rod. You might have to be leaving. I'm going out of town. Amen. Sister Pearl, you can come. But we're going to just pray that God will give us a format that involves everybody so everybody can get released in prayer. Amen.
Amen.